Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about hemophilia imaging. Demnology, H-linked recessive bleeding disorder resulting from clotting factor deficiency. Hemophilia A, more than 80% of kids factor A deficiency. Hemophilia B, less than 15% of kids factor 9 deficiency. Hemophilic arthropathy, progressive joint destruction due to recurrent hematrosis, synovitis, erosion. Most common signs and symptoms: acute hematrosis, hands swollen, red, painful joint occurring spontaneously or with minor trauma, plus minus leukocytosis and fever. Subacute or chronic hematrosis, degenerative arthrosis, decreased range of motion, contracture, pseudotumor, palpable mass, compression of adjacent structure. Demographic A, first episode of joint hemorrhage by 2-3 years of age, typical by time of ambulation. Repeated hematrosis throughout childhood. Hematrosis occurring decrease in older patients. Sex, male only. Up to one set are due to spontaneous mutation. Extremely rare female manifestation are seen with various chromosomal abnormality. Epidemiology. Hemophilia A, 1 over 5,000 male patients. Hemophilia B, 1 over 3,000 male patients. Imaging, location of arthropathy, ankle, more than knee, elbow, more than shoulder. Radiograph, distension of joint capsule by effusion and synovitis with eventual cartilage damage, erosion, and subchondrosis. Variable signal intensity and heterogeneity of effusion due to blood product of different age. Chronic hemosiderin deposit line synovium. Low signal intensity on all sequence in characteristic lobing of signal loss on during GOE. Eventual development of osteocartilaginous erosion. Ultrasound, effusion of variable echogenicity and vegetal synovial sickening with hyperemia by Doppler. Seeing irregularity of hyperechoic cartilage. This is T2 star GOE. AMA of the knee in a 7 years old with hemophilia A, so extensive lobing along the joint capsule due to prior episode of hematosis. Early cartilage irregularity is seen at the patella major and facet. Lateral and AP knee radiograph in the same patient 6 years later at the time of swelling, so a large damp joint fusion. The epiphysis are mildly large and irregular due to repeated hematrosis and synovitis causing local hyperemia and cartilage thinning. This is ultrasound image. Rise, elbow on the top and left elbow in the bottom. In a child with hemophilia A and right arm swelling, so a complex effusion, anterior distal right humerus, and radial neck. There is another flat at this place. No effusion is seen on the left. No more hypoechoic humerocapitular cartilage is seen bilaterally. AP radiograph on the left and T2FN in the right. In the same patient, saw overgrowth and irregularity of the larger head with associated cartilage loss at the radiocapitular articulation. AP knee radiograph saw a widened interspondylar notch along with joint space narrowing and subchondral bone erosion. These findings are typical of hemophilic arthropathy. AP radiograph of the bilateral elbow in an 18-year-old with hemophilia A show the long-standing effusion of recurrent hematuria, include irregular mishapen and overgrowth epiphysis with joint space narrowing. Its finding are due to synovitis with hyperemia, cartilage degeneration, and bony erosion. Treatment: hemophilic arthropathy, acute bleed, clotting factor joint aspiration. Chronic synovectomy, intra-articular hyaluronic acid, if end stage arthroplasty. Hemophilic pseudotumor, goal of preserved pattern, conservative immobilization, clotting factor, radical resection, and or radiation. Thank you.